Ucypher, India's first multi-gaming, multi-platform esports championship. Six teams of 14 players each compete across four games: Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Dota 2, Tekken 7, and Real Cricket 17. Each team faces the other team twice in the league stage, and 3 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Tekken 7 and Real Cricket 17 in each match. 5 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Dota 2 and CSGO games in a match. The top four teams in the league stage move to the knockout rounds. Ucypher, six teams, 84 cyber athletes, and a grand prize pool of 51 lakh rupees.
Hi guys, my name is Aisha, and you are watching Ucypher, new sport, new superstars. Professional gaming has been evolving over the last two decades, but it's really exploded over the last 5 years. Just like any other athlete, a professional gamer has to put hours and hours of practice. They have to study each other's gameplay and be truly dedicated to the sport.
The point where cyber athletes go one up over athletes of other sports is that games are changing every day. Today, the Yodhas go up against the Crusaders. So without wasting any more time, let the battle begin!
Kya baat hai yaar, bade khush dikhai de rahe ho. I thought sannata hone wala hai because you lost the last matchup. इतने खुश क्यों?
नया दिन है, obviously it's a new start.
पुरानी बातें भूल गए.
पुरानी बातें हम भूल गए, हम आगे बढ़ गए. So आज का दिन अच्छा होगा.
कैसे prepare किया?
हमने प्रैक्टिस की है, सब स्क्वाड ने, हमने टीम मीटिंग रखी थी, उसमें हमने काफ़ी बात की क्या गलत हो रहा है क्या नहीं हो रहा है, कोऑर्डिनेशन में मिस्टेक्स है, कम्युनिकेशन में मिस्टेक है, वो सब हमने फिक्स किया है. आज आर्ची भी काफ़ी कॉन्फिडेंट है, तो वो अच्छी स्टार्ट देगा आज.
The Crusaders! Wow, guys, lots of energy today. Are you excited about a brand new day of epic gaming on Ucypher?
Yes, totally. Past two games were not that good. But even after losing both the games, I think so the motivation in the team is like going up and up. And I think so today is the day that we have to make a comeback. And today is the day that we are going to be on the top.
Killer B, what about you? Have you been doing anything else apart from practicing real cricket these last few days?
I would prefer not to say anything now. जब तक मैं कोई गेम जीता नहीं हूँ, एंड एज सून एज आई एम विनिंग द गेम, पूरा दंगल होगा.
योद्धास, यूथ के लिए तैयार?
यार बिल्कुल तैयार. एक और चीज़ बोलना चाहूँगा वरुण, हमारा बोलता है कि हम युद्ध करने आते हैं, हम दिल जीत के जाएंगे. लेकिन आज हम दिल नहीं जीतेंगे, दिल बहुत जीत लिया, अभी थर्ड है. युद्ध करने आया पर मैच जीत के जाएंगे.
योद्धास ने बोला था क्या, दिल जीत के जाएंगे?
नहीं,
मैच जीत के जाएंगे. पहले तो दिल तो जीत रहे थे, आज अभी दोनों नहीं जीतेंगे. मैच तो जीत ही नहीं रहे, दिल भी गया.
Can't wait to see what the Crusaders do today. Let's start the day.
Welcome to Match Day 8 of Ucypher, where we have an action-packed lineup of games.
It's an interesting matchup today, especially because Crusaders have not yet won any of the single-player games.
Yes.
So it'll be interesting to see if they can pull it off today.
Exactly.
With Killer B in cricket and OZ in Tekken 7.
Killer B is woefully out of form. He really needs to find his form, Omar.
And on the other hand, OZ, he's not yet won a Tekken game.
Right.
So hopefully he sticks to one character out here today.
Yeah.
And perfectly executes the combination.
First up is a game that gets everybody raging. I'm talking about Bandai Namco's Tekken 7, which we play on the Sony PS4 platform. Players apne character select karenge. Har round mein jiska HP khatam ho jayega, wo round haar jayega. हर मैच एक रेस है 3 राउंड्स जीतने की, और जो प्लेयर पहले 3 मैचेस जीतेगा वो बनेगा टेकन 7 का विनर. लेट द बैटल बिगिन. फ्रॉम द योद्धास वी हैव आर्ची क्रिस्पी, एंड फ्रॉम द क्रुसेडर्स वी हैव ओजी. नन ऑफ दीस प्लेयर्स हैव वन अ सिंगल गेम ऑफ टेकन येट, सो क्लियरली वन ऑफ देम इज डेस्टिन्ड टू ब्रेक दैट रिकॉर्ड टुडे. बट लेट्स फाइंड आउट इफ दे हैव एक्चुअली वर्कड ऑन देयर स्किल्स एंड इफ दे पुट अप अ गुड शो फॉर अस.
Round 1. Fight.
Well, Uma
Yama being aggressive at the start, but perfect block coming in from Lucky Chloe. But now with a nice reply back on Kuma, he is taking some huge damage that Crusaders are not ready for. He is stuck into the corner, but now with a nice reply coming back on Lucky Chloe. And there goes the kick, but it's not going to reach at those tiny legs. And it's going to be Lucky Chloe who's going to knock out Kuma. Fight. Well, round two begins, and nice moves coming in from Kuma. Lucky Chloe taking some damage over there. She is low on HP, but now with a nice move of that freestyles. And she is giving him some lot of damage. Well, the rage art comes out of Kuma over there, but it has been blocked perfectly from Lucky Chloe. Now Lucky Chloe does have the rage art, but she won't need it as the slaps would work and Kuma is knocked out. Round number three, Lucky Chloe with those double flips coming in, but Kuma with perfect blocks. Well, he is showing us some nice skills over here. But again, he is really low on HP. He does have the rage art to work with. He is going low on, he's stuck into the corner, and Lucky Chloe is just finishing him off. It's gonna be match number one that goes to the Yodhas. Looks like a character change coming in for the Crusaders. Ozzy is gonna pick Law over here. Number two begins, and now it's gonna be Lucky Chloe again the same way. She is actually putting some pressure on Law over here. He is going low on HP. He does have the rage art to work with. He pulls out the rage art and it won't connect because the block coming in from Lucky Chloe, and she is going to finish him. But no, it's gonna be blocks coming in from Law as well. But the rage art does connect from Lucky Chloe, and she is gonna end this in style. What an amazing move coming in from Lucky Chloe in that round.
Round two, fight.
Well, round number two begins. Lucky Chloe is putting some pressure on Law over here because he is just getting into the corners. He doesn't have like much movement to do now because that corner pressure is real. Well, Lucky Chloe has made him really low on HP. He does have the rage art to work with, but I think so. He has actually wasted his rage art. Lucky Chloe is on the rage art, and yes, she pulls off the rage art, but no, she misses it. And what a great kick coming in for Law. Well, he does manage to pull one round for his team. So it's going to be round number three now. Law is putting up some pressure on Lucky Chloe with those punch, but Lucky Chloe with a nice comeback in the game. Well, she is trying to play a little bit defensive compared to what she was playing earlier, but those moves coming in, it's gonna hurt Law a lot. Again, he is stuck into the corner, does have the rage art to work with, but no time given from Lucky Chloe as he shuts him down. The match is going to round number four, and the game begins, and this time the pressure is going to be real as Lucky Chloe is not going to make this easy for Law because she is maintaining a distance, coming in aggressive again, and those punch and kicks is going to hurt him a lot. Well, Marshall Law does have the rage out right now, but it's going to be a knockout because Lucky Chloe knows what to do in the game. Well, looks like a character change popping in for Ozzy over here because he needs more characters in Tekken 7. I don't think so. It's not working for him. He's not practicing like a single character, but now looking at the game, he is putting a perfect pressure on Lucky Chloe. She does have the rage out to work with. And now the same pressure comes on to Horang as well. Both have the rage out on them. Who is gonna pull off it first? And it's gonna be Horang who misses it, but it's gonna be Lucky Chloe right now. And yes, it does connect, and this is gonna be surely a knockout with a style for Lucky Chloe.
Round two.
Round number two begins. Well, a high kick coming in for Lucky Chloe. That bounce was amazing from Horang, and she is going low and low on HP. Does have the rage art, but I don't know what time would it be to just pull it off, but no time given. It's gonna be a knockout, and Horang managed to pull one more round for the Crusaders. Lucky Chloe just being aggressive on Horang right now because she knows it's gonna be a lot of pressure if he gets more rounds. So she does want to end this right now. Well, she is putting up some pressure on Horang, but Horang pulls out the rage art, and no, it does not connect because it's gonna be a block coming in from Lucky Chloe, and she is gonna knock him out in an easy way coming
round
in.
Round four.
It's gonna be the last round for Lucky Chloe. If she wins this, they are gonna get those 3 points in their pockets for easy. And now looking at the HP of Horang, it doesn't look like they are gonna win this because now it's gonna be Lucky Chloe to show us some nice moves. But Horang coming back with a nice reply, but Lucky Chloe as well. She is putting some damage on Horang right now. And this is gonna be the end, as the Yodhas are your winners for Tekken 7.
Crispy, what so a much. Game, Yodhas. Are you proud of him or not? Because I am. What a game. I mean, you went at it. And you didn't have the chance. Just sledging chal rahi thi yahan se.
Completely.
Bura lag raha tha.
Haan, I've done my homework. I knew what to do. And I'm prepared now for the future games.
All the very best, Yodhas. All the best, Captain. I hope the best for you.
Yeah. Let's go!
Long sixes, quick running between the wickets, and cheeky runs. The game that I'm talking about is Real Cricket 17 by Nautilus Mobiles.
ये एक batting only match है. हर player एक over face करेगा जिसमें उसे maximum runs बनाने होंगे. Maximum runs बनाने वाला player match जीत जाएगा. Tie होने पर दोनों players एक super over खेलेंगे to decide the winner.
With me, I have the captains of Yodha, Vaz, and the captain of Crusaders, Remstar. Who'll call?
I'll call.
All right.
Heads.
You win the toss.
He will bat second.
That means you're chasing and you are batting first. All the best, captains. May the best team win.
Here to show off his Real Cricket 17 skills, we have Killer B from the Crusaders. Killer B, is this easy peasy for you? कि थोड़ा डर लग रहा है?
Pressure है क्योंकि दो games में जीता नहीं हूँ, so डर, pressure, सब कुछ like nervousness, everything is there.
How excited are you playing this game? Because Archie Crispy has already set the bar really high.
Excited हूँ और जीतने के लिए भी ready हूँ.
आज कितना score expect कर रहे हो?
जितना भी score बनाऊँगा उसके लिए काफी है.
You know उनका last game score कितना था?
7 I think.
Can you beat that? मुश्किल है ना, बहुत मुश्किल है.
ट्राई करूंगा
कुछ बोलना चाहोगे?
ट्विंकल ट्विंकल रैम स्टार, कितना स्कोर बनाएगा? 3 या 4?
ऑल द बेस्ट कुनवा, ऑल द बेस्ट कैप्टन, मे द बेस्ट टीम विन.
Welcome to the Ucypher League today. It's going to be Sachin who's going to bat first for the Yodhas. And the first ball comes in, and that's a nice hit, and the ball is going for a 4, just like an inch away from 6. But nevertheless, it was a good ball, so 4 runs coming in already for the Yodhas. This is going to be the second ball, and that's a huge hit, so it's going for a 6. So 10 runs already to the Yodhas. The ball goes in, and again a nice hit. It's gonna go for a 4, so Yodhas are playing really, really good. The ball goes in, and again a huge hit. It's going for a 6. It says, will he repeat it again, and will it go for a 4? And yes, it goes for a 4. This is the last ball. I expect a 6 from him just to go for 30 runs, and he has done it. It's gonna go for a 6, 30 runs. What an amazing game. So now it's going to be the Crusaders who need 31 runs to win the game. Well, it's all on Killer B right now, who is batting for the Crusaders. The ball one goes in, a nice hit towards the boundary, just an inch away, but it goes for a 4. Ball number 2 going in, and this is a nice hit. Looks like he is actually going from the same strategy that Yodhas were going at, 4 and 6. So is this gonna be a 4 and a nice hit? Is this gonna be a 6? And yes, it is. So nice score already. He is showing us some that like he can go for a victory for this game. And again, a nice hit from his side. And this ball is going for a 4. So last 2 balls left. He does need 11 runs from this ball. So that means 2 sixes in a row will get him a direct victory. And now the ball he has hit, but it's gonna go for a 4. So now he has only 1 ball left. He need 6 runs to draw this game. The ball goes in, and he has hit it. Oh my god, will it go? And yes, it's a 6. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going for a super over. Super over begins. It's going to be Sachin who's going to go for the bat first. This is going to be a pretty intense game because it has gone for a super over. The first ball goes in and he again has hit it for a six. I think though, but there's a player who's going to catch it and he is out. Well, ball number two goes in. It's a nice shot going for four runs. So finally managing to get four runs on the Yodha side. The Crusaders looking very chilled right now. And that's a dot ball that sad faces on the Yodha side. This is going to be the fourth ball and it comes in and he has given a good shot over here, but it's not a four, so he'll have to actually make few runs. And let's see how many he does make it, and it's only going to be three runs. This is a really good shot on the fifth ball. It goes for a six. So he's definitely going to make 13 runs right now. And this is the last ball. Let's see. And it's a call for how's that? And no, it's a not out. But still, it was zero runs on the last ball. So Crusaders now need 14 runs to win this game. So it's now all on Killer B. Let's see what happens in the game. It's going to be the first ball and he hits it and it's going for a six. So amazing game coming in for the Crusader side. And the second ball goes in for a six as well. What an amazing performance. He just needs two runs and that's all for the Crusaders to win it, and he has hit it. So this is going for a definitely a six. Ladies and gentlemen, your winners, Crusaders in the Super Over.
What a killer performance. Teen ball, teen chakke, there was just no stopping you. You demolished them. That must have really stung them. Guys, what do you think? So practice kaam aaye clearly.
Bahut kaam aaye. And maine wahi bola tha ki jab tak main ek game jeetunga nahi tab tak main kuch kho, like you know, I won't say anything. Baaki log ko sirf ye bolunga ki mere ko halke mein mat lo. Ye sher abhi jaag gaya.
Hopefully, the Crusaders are going to keep this streak going. This was an epic performance. I think the most easy win in Real Cricket 17 that we have seen in Ucypher so far. So congratulations for that, man. Congratulations, Crusaders! It's time to shift gears and move into our five-pointer games. The game that has sold over 25 million units across the franchise is CSGO by Valve Corporations.
इस गेम में दो टीम्स होती हैं, एक टेररिस्ट टीम और दूसरी काउंटर टेररिस्ट टीम। ये एक टीम बेस्ड गेम है जो 5 वर्सेस 5 के फॉर्मेट में खेला जाएगा। प्लेयर्स कौन सा मैप खेलेंगे, ये एक बैनिंग प्रोसेस से तय होगा। शुरुआत में दोनों टीम्स को $800 की गेम करेंसी मिलती है। The aim of the terrorist team is to plant the bomb and secure it or kill all the counter terrorists. The aim of the counter-terrorist team is to either defuse the bomb or kill all the terrorists. इस मैच में 30 rounds होंगे and the first team to win 16 rounds is the game winner. In the case of a tie, the result will be decided with a race to 4 wins.
सही बात मैप्स की, वो वीटो पे डिसाइड होगा।
ट्रेड पे ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है, पहला अगर पिक अगर मिल रहा है तो ठीक है, पर ट्रेड होना चाहिए अगर वो पहला वाला बंदा मर गया तो।
थोड़ा ध्यान रखना, वो लोग के दो प्लेयर ऐसे पेक्सर और मार्केलोन, जो अगर मारना चालू करते तो फिर उन्हें रोकना बहुत हार्ड होता है।
इन्फर्नो और कैश हम लोग ले सकते हैं पिक कर सकते
हैं।
रेस और मिराज बैन कर देते हैं, मिराज वो लोग काफी पगे स्टाइल खेलते हैं, काफी रैंडम खेलेंगे तो डिफिकल्ट होगा जीतने के लिए।
हां वीटो जो है वही रखते हैं, चल रहा है जीत रहे।
सो गाइस यार जीतना है ये गेम,
लाइटली मत लो, अपने को जीतना ही है।
वो लेट्स गो गाइस,
गो योद्धा।
Kavish and Waz, this game of CSGO is going to be a tiebreaker of sorts because both the Yodhas and the Crusaders are at 3 points each. What was going on in the strategy rooms?
We have practiced some basic stuffs and we are ready for them.
तो कुछ अलग करने वाले हो?
अलग तो करेंगे लेकिन बताएंगे नहीं। पर हाँ एक चीज जरूर बताएंगे, हम लोग का core player वापिस आ गया है Rex.
Okay, Rex is back.
Yeah.
तो इसका मतलब है you'll have to bench somebody from the previous lineup.
Yeah, who's we that? Have to bench Bumblebee, I guess.
Bumblebee.
Yeah.
Okay. Who are you guys benching this time?
We'll be benching Reflex. We're going with the same lineup, okay. The winning combination, and yeah.
You were the MVP in your previous round, and so were you. Have you guys seen each other play before?
Yeah, we have played together also.
You played together?
Yeah, and against also.
And against. What worked better for you?
Together.
Together. Wow, I can't wait for this to begin. All the best. All the best. Kill it, guys. Clearly, lots of surprises await us in this game of CSGO as the Crusaders go up against the Yodhas. I can't wait. I'm sure you can't either. So let's go straight to it.
This is the map, Vito, and now let's see what do they choose. And it's gonna be Inferno. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is me, Jireen, and today it's gonna be the Yodhas versus the Crusaders, and this is gonna be the knife round. So now let's see who's gonna be the winner for the knife round, as the winner gets to choose the side and what they're gonna play. So it's Inferno, a pretty much city-sided game.
जब knife round चालू हुआ, तो हम लोग तो काफी confidence में गए, अपनी रान पूरी निकाल गए कि चलो चलो अभी मारने अब, लेकिन हार गए.
Let's see what are the strategies coming on for them for the CT side. Well, Magic is holding towards mid. Well, he starts with the first frag on Marklon. He is very aggressive, but that aggression didn't pay off. So Marklon goes down for as the first frag. When Flash popping in towards the alley side, of the players have to back off from the location over there. And Pexa is gonna go for a fight, and what a reflex coming in from him. And Chris manages to pull down one player and second frag as well. It's gonna be Rizla who's gonna shut him down. And instant frag coming in from Magic as well, as he shuts down Rizla and making this win for the Crusaders. Round number two begins. The players are slowly moving towards the bomb site A and pretty much camping towards the upper house.
So round two mein wo log ne force buy kiya tha, and unko all in hi jana tha ki अगर टेररिस्ट में अगर वो लोग सेकंड राउंड जीत जाते हैं उनके लिए बहुत बड़ा एडवांटेज है, बिकॉज़ सीटी के सारे पैसे खत्म हो जाते हैं.
They are just pushing in YOLO, and this is not looking good as Krish is going to shut down two players and Kavish as two as well. It was a pretty bad strategy coming in for the Yodhas over there. They need to build up some strategies.
तो मुझे पता था रेक्स आगे से खेलेगा स्मोक में. मैंने जस्ट स्मोक में ऐसे ही फायर किया, रेक्स मर गया. और जब ही स्मोक गया, मैंने और पेक्सर ने वॉक इन करके कंट्रोल लिया. वैसे ही हम लोग साइट रैप अप किया आज से, और वो लोग हम लोग को साइट पे दो बंदे फ्री में मिले, हम लोग ने उनको मार दिया.
He gets a nice shot through the smoke, and Pexa is gonna plant the C4. Well, Chris with a huge economy on his side. Well, he does have the AWP he needs to save, but it's gonna be Rizla who's gonna shut him down and not let him save. Well, one point added to the Yodhas side. Well, 1 minute 40 seconds on the clock. Rizla pushing in, very aggressive. He gets two instant frags. What a shot coming in by him. And Rex pushing towards Ali. Well, he does get Friction, who was camping towards Ali. And Kavish holding a nice sneaky posy on the bomb side, as a player don't know. But Pexen now knows, already pre-spraying towards the corner. And yes, he gets one frag. He's going down with the C4 now.
2-on-2 round chalu tha. Main tha aur mera bhai tha Pexen. Pexen ne shot liya mid to right pe aur wo mar gaya. तो मैंने वहाँ पे कैंप करके मिट्टू लेफ्ट वाले को पहले अच्छे से मारा, फिर सेकंड वाला मेरे को पता था मेरे पे चढ़ने ही वाले, बिकॉज वन ऑन वन था, उसको चढ़ना था, बॉम्ब प्लान था, उसको C4 डिफ्यूज भी करना था. तो जैसे ही वो आया मारने, मैंने उसको मार दिया.
The mollies and nades going in towards the alley, and it's gonna be Kavish who's just barely alive in that fire. Like the fire is not touching him, he is just staying. It's god of luck or what, I don't know, but Marklon graining in those frags. Already three frags coming in for Marklon. The site is pretty much clear for them, and they can move into the site right now. Well, Buzz is just gonna plant the C4, and it's not looking good for the Crusaders, as they are also on an eco round. So not much buy coming in from them. A player comes in from mid. It's gonna be Pexa who's gonna shut down Krish. And alone left is the survivor who's not gonna win the round. So 3v3 the current scoreline, and Yodhas do manage to make the score equal. Magic being aggressive towards mid. He's gonna shut down Rizla over there and going for the second frag as well. He is just playing like a beast with that USB. He doesn't need a weapon to just kill them. It's gonna be 4 easy and instant frags coming in for Magic. What an amazing game. Well, Chris holding a nice angle towards the T slope, and yes, he does manage to get down Wurz. It's gonna be Pexa looking like a nice smoke going in for the CT block.
मिड राइट पहले क्लियर किया, मिड लेफ्ट गए स्लोली स्लोली वॉक करके. हम लोगों ने सोचा था कुछ भी आवाज़ नहीं करी, उन लोगों को एकदम सरप्राइज करना है हमें. पता चल गया कि अभी इसको तो एकदम ऑफ गार्ड पकड़ लिया, एक को मारा फटाक से दूसरे को मार दिया, थर्ड का भी मिल गया मस्त.
Kamish holding the side, managed to pull down two guys, but not for long as Rizla is gonna take a revenge and making it a 2v1 situation, and Magic alone left in this situation, a 1v2 fight for him. He doesn't know where the player are holding, and there's a player who is his right, it's gonna be Friction who's gonna shut him down, making it a 6-4 the scoreline. But the players are moving towards the alley and not looking good. An instant trade made by both the teams. A 4v4 situation currently. And Krish managed to pull one more frag and one man advantage coming on for the Crusaders. And instantly, as I say, it's not looking good because the Yodhas one by one, they are going down. Was left in a 1v3 situation. He is planting the C4. Still 35 seconds for the C4 now. And Krish is moving from the alley. He spots Was over there. And yes, he does connect. He gets on that easy frag onwards. A 7-7 scoreline, equalizing the score. This is looking good for both of them. Pretty much an equal score. But on the CT side, 7-7 scoreline. Can't say much. Well, Rex holding the angle perfectly towards the alley. And he gets one frag through the smoke. And Magic is also going to shut down Pexa. It's just raining frag each and everywhere on the alley side. This was just a YOLO push coming in from the Yoda. So 8-7, a perfect scoreline for the perfect first half. It's going to be second half for this game. 8-7, the current scoreline. One round lead on the Crusader side.
मैं और रिजला दोनों गए वहाँ पे और हम दोनों ने शूटिंग करना चालू किया. वो लोग चार जन वहाँ पे थे, लेकिन वो टाइम पे रिजला को दो किल मिल गया. फिर हमने फॉल बैक कर दिया, हम साइड पे आ गए.
Rizla does manage to pull down two players easily. Now moving towards the alley side. It's gonna be Rex who's gonna shut down Friction, and Marklon coming in with one more frag. And the second frag as well with a nice headshot with power, still managing to stay alive and just trying the round, but no, not for long because Was is gonna shut him down. A push coming towards the alley. Friction does manage to pull only one frag for his team. It's gonna be Magic from the Crusader side, just left alone in this situation. But no, it's gonna be Pexa who's gonna shut him down. Well, Pexa is just on a rage mode right now. And what about a single tap coming in from Marklon?
मैंने डीगल ली, आर्मर ली और मैं मिड पे गया. और रेक्स मेरे को मिला उधर बैठा था. मैंने उसको बहुत अच्छा शॉट मारा. मैं बी पे गया, फाउंटेन पे बैठ गया, वो मेरे एम पे आया, मर गया उधर. पर मैं लाल था इसलिए मेरे को मार दिया उसने बाद में.
And a tap coming in from Marklon as well. One more easy tap headshot for Marklon over there, making it a 1v4 situation. And Kavish is the lone survivor left over here, but not for long as Was is gonna shut him down. So nice lead coming towards the Yodhas. Marklon with the perfect angle towards the alley side. He's gonna pick up Magic and gonna run for his life. Well, Molly's popping in just to like block off the vision for the players. Well, he is still gonna stick to his pose. He spots one, he gets down one. An instant frag made over there. Well, Pexa is gonna go in and rain bullets on them, and he's gonna get two easy frags. And Was backing him up with one more frag. Well, Pexa is currently on the beast mode. I don't know what's going on within him, and he gets one frag, two frags through the smoke, making it look so easy for him. And he's still waiting for more frags. One frag, two frag, more. Total of four frags coming in for Pexa, and it's gonna be power left in the situation. Well, he goes down by Rizla.
मैं तो एकदम खुला सांड बन गया था. I was just totally unleashed. Right click flash किया मैंने खुद ही उसके smoke के through ही मैंने बुझ लिया. एक जन मिला मेरे को और दो जन 30 लोग और मिले. मस्त एस मार दिया मैंने. 10 साल से खेल रहा यार, ऐसे थोड़ी आके मेरे को मार सकता है कोई.
And yes, it's an ace. He kills all five of them straight in a row, winning this game for his team. Well, it's gonna be Yoda 16 and Crusaders 9. So Yoda's taking that 5 points and winning this game easily.
What an epic game of CSGO, guys. Remstar, what went wrong?
The game was going good. Like at a point, it was even. And then the crucial round happened when they were eco. And we did not check the stack that they had done. And then that round they won. And from then, Praxis just took away the game from us totally.
was you must be on cloud 9, especially with Pexar's performance. He went ballistic, 31 kills.
It was a very good game. He nailed it, really. He was carrying us throughout the game because I was not hitting my shots.
Right.
Nobody was hitting their shots, but Pexar took it. Like, he proved it, like, he deserved 2,800 points, which I bid on him.
Absolutely. And we saw him ending the game with an ace. That is super rare. I have to say, Pexar really, really surprised all of us. You have 8 points now. Yeah. You guys are still at 3, but there's still one more game left. You guys can salvage your defeat this time and you guys can maintain your lead. Which one it's gonna be, that's up to you. We have Dota 2. There's still time for both the teams to show off their skills and prove who's best. Catch you then.
With me, I have the captain of the Crusaders, the in-game leader of Dota and vice-captain of the Yodhas. Captain, you last game baithe the because you said that you have to play this game with your friend. Your friend is right here. तो इनको हराने में कितना मजा आएगा आज
बुरा लगेगा क्योंकि स्कूल टाइम से जानते एक दूसरे को एंड डोटा भी स्टार्ट में ही खेला था अगेंस्ट भी खेला था जब अगेंस्ट खेला था इसने हमेशा हराया था मुझे तो टाइम है कि पे बैक
आज तक आप यूसाइफर में एक डोटा गेम नहीं जीते हो आज का गेम आपकी टीम के लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है तो आज जीतने दोगे या फिर जीतोगे
जीतने तो मैं किसी को नहीं दूंगा उनको अगर जीतना है तो उनको एक टफ गेम खेलना पड़ेगा हम लोग के अगेंस्ट सो लेट्स सी व्हाट हैपेंस
ऑल द बेस्ट
थैंक्स मैन
All the best. May the best captain win.
Dota 2 में हर प्लेयर अपने लिए एक हीरो सिलेक्ट करेंगे इस गेम में दो टीम्स कम्पीट करेंगी इन अ 5v5 फॉर्मेट हर हीरो के पास स्पेशल पावर्स और एबिलिटीज होती हैं। हर टीम का ऑब्जेक्टिव है अपने एंशियंट्स को डिफेंड करना और अपने ओपोनेंट के सारे टावर्स को डिस्ट्रॉय कर देना जो टीम पहले एनिमी टीम के डिफेंस को तोड़कर उनके सारे टावर्स डिस्ट्रॉय कर देगी वो टीम जीतेगी
Live with Ucypher, Nasport, 9 Superstars. My name is Vivek, with me is CloudX, and you're watching Crusaders on the Dire, facing off versus the Yodhas on the Radiant.
Top lane, Kale going in, they've got the Shackles coming out on Remstar, Spectre, Crusaders on the receiving end of the blows, but Deja Vu, Sun from behind, Bakemono's coming in, it's a return kill for Bakemono, but first blood goes to 11 on the Night Stalker, as both Kale and 11 will try to make a run for it. Bakemono can't quite give chase.
Bottom lane, Shanti dropping really low here. Needs to be careful. Darshan though, they've got the Shadow Shaman coming in and with the Shackles, they have enough to find the kill. Darshan, the Atrophy Aura is doing some work versus Shanti there. He drops the Fire Stomp. He's drawing this fight out and it seems as if he's going to get away. It is nighttime and 11's got that movement speed. The Void comes through and Deja Vu gets the kill.
Middle lane, 7 minutes and now it's 2-1 in favor of the Radiant. It looks like Invincible for Crusaders is going to get himself a kill here as well with Deja Vu going down. It is a kill to the Tinker. 11 though, and Gandhi still going forward. Bakemono getting slowed up and brought down as well. The Starstorm doing some heavy damage early on here. Chen ends up getting taken out. Good arrow from Gandhi, smacks him right in the middle of the forehead with a double Starstorm. Remstar goes down. It's 5-2 in favor of the Yodhas. They're gonna get themselves a tower on the bottom lane. And...
But Morphling was playing more ahead of the game. So, tabhi, I think Underlord mein aur Lich the. Usko hum log chase kar rahe the. To wo jhaadiyon mein chale gaya tha. But mere ko pata tha wo TP out karega, teleport out karega base ke liye. To maine ek centaur uske piche hi rakha tha. To jaise hi wo TP chalu kiya, maine stun kiya. To hume wo easy kill mil gaya.
Yeah, Shandi's gonna be a little disappointed with himself. That waveform into a cliff. It couldn't go past that. There's no free pathing just yet for a Morphling. Top lane, Ramstar just catching up in farm. Seems like he's going for the Mask of Madness, but look at this. Trying to shut him down. The Impale is there. The Cut the Shackles as well. TPs are coming in, but I'm not sure the Tinker can do too much, and Hale gets the kill.
In favor of the Yodhas on the middle lane, though, they then finish the job on Deja Vu with the Spectre Haunt as well, the tower. But Nightstalker is coming here to put a stop to that, along with the Vendetta Lich Assassin. They will snipe off a hero on the back, but as I say, that Lich even ends up surviving and gets sent back to the base by Bakemono. They get a return kill on Hale and then finish the job on Deja Vu with the Spectre Haunt as well.
Hi guys. Okay, Bumblebee, what's up right now? What's happening?
Currently, the game is going on both sides, like it's going equally.
So, abhi barabar chal raha hai. I'm gonna leave these guys right here. They look very nervous.
The fight was huge for the Crusaders. Getting a tier 1 tower, ensuring that the Lich survives, and getting a couple of key kills.
Crusaders has a lineup that's meant to snowball. A couple of early towers means that they get super strong. I'm not sure if Yodhas is at the point where they can contest him now with 3 centaurs, a bit of malice on Deja Vu, and a rocket for good measure. Darshan finishes him off with a firestorm, and that means they're gonna get themselves a tier 2 tower. Just 19 minutes in, they're coming knocking close to the high ground of the Yodhas.
Yeah, good stuff coming up from them. They've got the early mech on the Underlord, like you mentioned. They are snowballing quite heavily. And all of this is space for Remstar to just farm. So if, in case this game does go late, they've got that security in the late game.
It's not going late. 22 minutes in. They're already beating up on a tier 3 tower. The defense is coming.
Oh, bit of malice on the 3. Firestorm to follow. But there's no further lockdown. Invincible just blinks in. Let's lose a couple of rockets and a laser. Forcing 11 to shrine. But he's caught in the march and in the pit. He's going to end up going down to the centaur stun. The tier 3 tower falls as well. It's all going horribly wrong for the Yodhas.
He does manage to get away, but not far enough because Kale's gonna die instead.
Bakemono and Darshan will focus the melee barracks. Kale just blinks in, lands a huge impale, but where's the follow-up? He's being pushed to Spike Carapace, trying to run away, but the Frost Blast from Senjin will secure the kill. Shandi, Adaptive Strike, pushing them back. They've got the Greaves though, it's healing them up, and Deja Vu goes in with the Shackles, ends up going down to Invincible and Darshan.
Yodhas are just getting overwhelmed at this point. Crusaders have just come, stood their ground, and taken a lane of barracks. Now it looks like Yodhas want to try and fight back, but Invincible is up on the high ground, spamming rocket after rocket, and Dagan for good measure, and a laser to finish the job on the Nightstalker. With one down on either side, it looks like Yodhas are feeling confident about going in, but the Chain Frost is bouncing. Gandhi gets hit by it twice. Senjin trying to run here, has a Morphling on his heels, but Remstar's here to join the party as well and goes to work on Shandi. You've got the Morphling trying to get away, but Invincible comes in from behind and finishes up on Gandhi while Deja Vu attempts a TP out. He does manage to get away, but not far enough because Kale's gonna die instead. On the side, the arrow will miss because of a creep coming in the way, but it looks like Bakemono spotted out this smoke rotation coming in from behind. Now they've got the walls thrown down, the Chain Frost as well. It's a bloodbath on the top lane, and Invincible is the victor of it all here versus Yodhas. Down on the side of Yodhas, and they'll tap out before they reach the base. It's all over, Yodhas. Crusaders will take the win here at Ucypher versus Yodhas, and will cement themselves as contenders in this tournament.
That was a fantastic game. Captain, you're back. You led the team and you got the victory for them. Fantastic. The scores right now are Yodhas at 8 and Crusaders, you are at 8-2. It's a tie. Yodhas are in Ucypher mein second row. You come to a line tak aate and you can't cross it. And that is Dota 2 for you.
It is heartbreaking. Feel bad. We'll make big changes for sure. Lineup's gonna be changed for sure for the next game. Let's see, hoping for the best.
Well, you have an entire league ahead of you. Coming back to the winning captain, aapki pura Dota team achhi hai, no doubt. But my favorite, Invincible Hussain, has again taken my heart. What a fantastic game by him. Being the youngest player in the Dota team, also in the entire league. And he's playing with such experienced players. What a fantastic show. Kuch bolna chahoge uske bare mein?
I had just had the confidence on him and he's just showing it. I've said this again, he's the best player in the tournament right now.
Well, I'm pretty sure Crusaders will be partying tonight and I would want to be a part of the party. Congratulations.
Thanks,
congratulations to you too.
We're into the third leg here with the Yodhas and they seem to be the draw kings of Ucypher so far. I'm with Kunal, aka Pexer. Hey. Kunal, what's going on with the draws here? Because again, just that finishing touch isn't quite there.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening. Like, we are winning our game, CS. Yeah. CS, we are winning our best. The rest of the games, unfortunately, are winning. So
So yeah, just keeping up the flow.
Yeah, this time as well, you started well with Tekken, a win there. You right. lost cricket, won CS, right. and then lost Dota. So yes. it was a draw versus these guys, which I guess is a mixed feeling, right? Were you happy with the draw overall?
No, not really. We just want to win. CS mein hopefully abhi hum log jeet rahe hain, so that is good. But we want to win in other games as well. And yeah. mainly Dota because uske zyada points hai.
And CS ke bare mein agar hum baat karenge, to it's only positive because you won 3 CS games
right.
on the trot.
Right.
How good does that feel, especially being a CS specialist yourself?
Right. It feels amazing. We know like we've made a team jo matlab CS mein kafi strong hai aur baaki har team ko hara sakti hai. We have like few teams jo hame kam tough de gaye, lekin hopefully we'll win in CS.
Well, it's been your third match. Two right. wins and two losses in this one as well. So 8 points apiece. Shared the spoils in this one, but plenty of time still to go in Ucypher for these guys, the Yodhas.
With this, we come to an end of day 8 of Ucypher Naya Sport Nice Superstars.
Before we take your leave, let's have a look at our ever-changing leaderboard as it stands today. Head over to usports.in to catch the entire gameplay today for yourself. So see you folks tomorrow as the Shaders challenge the Marksmen. This is Ucypher, a U Sports initiative. And my name is Aisha.
And I'm Varun.
Do Ucypher.